Alright, so this is embarrassing. So after reading your comments from part 2 of the series, I realized that I had to manually scan the panels, not interact with them. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nick, as always. You can call me Tetra Ninja, and we're once again back playing some Mass Effect 3. Mass Effect Andromeda. I had threes on my mind because there was three panels. Last session, we got the Tempest, our new spaceship, kind of akin to the Normandy. And we'd give you guys a tour of that ship, and now I kind of just hightailed it back onto the Nexus to wrap up the side mission, so.
Pathfinder, to cover their tracks, the Saboteur is overloading power to this panel from another junction relay. You can scan and trace the connective wiring to locate the surrogate panel.
Oh, okay. So I have to follow the line. It's going in here. Surrogate panels. Smart ones.
Scanning power junction relays. This panel is malfunctioning. Without more data, I cannot determine if this is a normal malfunction or sabotage.
I'll just disable power to the panel until Raj can check it out.
The heck is this guy doing? Squatting. So yeah, as well, when I return back into the Nexus, some lady jumped me, so we're gonna talk to her after as well. Okay, there's only one left then. And it is next, maybe it was...
Scan and trace the wiring to locate the panel that the Saboteur used.
Upstairs.
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power from the Hyperion.
Nexus Control, I'm getting an odd automatic.
Pathfinder, I received the data from Sam. It really is sabotage.
Any idea as to who it might be?
Yeah. All these panels were worked on by Zara. I just can't believe it.
Security video logs confirm that Zara Kellis worked on these panels, as well as the one Raj Patil encountered.
Well, shit. Any idea where she is now?
Kellis is currently working on a panel on the Hyperion main deck.
On my ship? Confront the Saboteur, not my ship, but, you know. Okay. Head up. No, I have to head out of here. Raj Patil. It does. That's like the. It's like they decided to come up with like the most Indian name ever. it's funny. Where are you? Sprint! You.
Zara Kellis?
Yes?
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the scans to prove it. Here, I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing, and it led us to you.
My scans point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
The real Saboteur could be setting you both up.
Because we both figured out something was going on? That would make sense. It's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless. Wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams. Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it really her?
Wasn't her. She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's been messing with you both. Just keep a low profile and don't talk to anyone. I'm on it.
Hey, you're from my ship. Lonnie.
Pathfinder, it's good to see you. Word is there's been trouble on the station.
We're here now. It'll get better.
That's what I've been telling people. You're here now. As soon as we establish outposts, everything will even out. I'm sure of it.
What about your family?
I'm an orphan. My parents died on the Mindoir colony when it was attacked years ago. No siblings. I left some friends and distant relatives behind. But I have friends here too. I love piloting. But I like the idea of going back to my roots and farming like my parents did. Someday.
You're the one that hit that gigantic galactic hairball. Joker wouldn't have hit it. Just saying.
Why did you join the initiative?
The most popular question on the station. Honestly, I wouldn't have known about this project if Nozomi hadn't reached out to me.
Nozomi?
Captain Dunn. Of all the captains I've piloted for, she's the best. I've always been a wanderer at heart. When she asked me to be her pilot, how could I say no to the adventure of a lifetime?
How do you feel about all this now that we're here?
Hopeful. I know, it's a rose-colored outlook, but someone's gotta keep the positivity coming, right?
Have to go now. See you later.
You be careful out there.
Mm-hmm. Alright. So, since I talked to Kendros, I now have access to all the Nexus security cameras. I just have to take the fake loading screen tram back again. Oh, BioWare, your methods have not changed. Security cameras.
This file is useless. Let's check another. And another scrambled file.
Coincidence seems unlikely.
Let's check another.
The hell?
This file is also corrupted. Definitely not a coincidence. You'd need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Someone working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled. But if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
Don't mind me as I get right in your face to scan you.
Negative match.
It's kind of invasive, ain't it? Oh, there's a shifty guy. Shifty guy.
Biometrics do not match.
Yeah. Fine. We'll head back to the Hyperion.
Tempest crew should report to the docking area at once.
Oh, wait. Truth is my sister. She'll be in the Cairo Bay. Who? Angry woman. Why are you angry at me, lady?
You, Pathfinder. I have a word or two for you.
Is there a problem?
Your father is my problem. He's everyone's problem.
We're all paying for Alec Ryder's ego. He preyed on Jean Garson's trusting nature and bulldozed us to this godforsaken place. Now she's dead, and we'll all soon follow.
This might be my dad's mess, but I will clean it up.
Talk about ego. You're no different from him. You think you could do this all yourself. Go to hell, Pathfinder.
Jesus, man. They're not like us here.
Scan results show a partial positive. Target is most likely suspect.
You.
Dale Atkins, right? We need to talk.
Look, not to be rude, but I have work to do.
Is that what sabotage is called these days? Work?
You're pretty arrogant for the new kid. You don't even know what's been going on.
Proof says you've been up to no good.
Vigors. Screw this. Screw all you hypocrites on this station.
You weren't here when they kicked out our loved ones. Mutiny? We just wanted answers. My sister is out there. I don't even know if she's alive or...
I'm sorry for what happened, but setting explosives isn't the answer.
Neither was sending people into exile because they didn't agree with policy. I don't care what you think. The mutiny leaders were right to demand to know what was going on.
You could have hurt people. Killed them.
Like those who got killed when the leadership had the Krogan stomp on my friends? I'm done talking. I confess, it was me. Do whatever you want.
Not my call. The Nexus leaders will make that decision.
That lot make a decision? That'll be the day.
Arrest that man. Do we just let him walk away? What?
What's the latest about waking people up?
I got some sweet XP though. Oh, Captain Dunn.
Ryder.
You're not on the bridge, Captain?
We powered it down. Can't afford to waste energy. Though Cryo Bay and Sam Note are exempt. And I told them to keep their hands off Alec's quarters. You have access now.
Thanks.
Hey, sorry about your father. He was really good at what he did. Just not so good at working with people. He was right about going planetside, though.
As long as they did their jobs, he didn't care what people thought of him.
I noticed that. If there's anything else I can help with, let me know.
Now that the Hyperion is docked, what'll you do?
Normally, I'd supervise thawing out the colonists, but that's been put on hold. I hear you're the one helping resolve the issue. Good luck with that.
If someone had told you that you'd be in the Andromeda cluster, even 5 years ago...
Are you kidding me? I'd have laughed them out of the quadrant. Although, the way things are now isn't exactly what I was hoping for, either. We all knew there was a possibility on arrival of less than ideal circumstances. When you sign up, you hope for the best, and plan for the worst.
Why did you join the Initiative? We're a long way from home.
How could I not? I love my job. Coming here, all this, it was just a logical extension of what I already do. Sailing through new stars, discovering new worlds. What self-respecting explorer could pass that up?
Thanks for the talk.
All right. I have requests to submit, administrators to harass, and people to wake up. I'd better get to it. Good luck out there.
Guess my dad has quarters as well in the cryo bay. So let's take the atrium. We're in the atrium right now. So we have two places for our Faja to hang. So let's take the tram to cryo bay. I want to see my sister. Should visit her. I would have thought they would have moved her to the Tempest, but I guess not. All right, so operations cryo bay. Journal. I just want to make sure that that was. Yeah, it's completed. Okay. Yeah, right there. Yeah, it gave me the complete sign. Alright. Looks like there's another mission over here. Getting close to it.
I'll make it right, Dash. Pathfinder, I'm Nigel McCoy. Just got out of cryo.
Welcome to Andromeda, Nigel.
Thank you. It's bittersweet, though. My little brother Dash was stationed on the Nexus. I just learned he died on Eos, trying to start a settlement.
That's awful. I'm sorry, Nigel.
Yeah. We were going to start families out here together. I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
That's a big ask, man.
Looks like the muscles bruised. The good Greer, how are you feeling?
I'm sure grateful. If you and Liam hadn't found me in that cave, God knows what those aliens would have done.
We couldn't leave a man behind.
Yeah, your father, and Kirkland.
We'll never forget their sacrifice. It's a brave thing, risking your life for the greater good.
Yeah, just seems unfair. We barely got here. I'm sorry I'm not out there with you, but Kirkland was a friend, and I'm not cut out for this anymore.
Understood. Habitat 7 was a nasty wake-up call. You take care, Greer.
You too. Thanks again.
Excuse me, we were having a conversation. You kind of just jumped in. I wonder if there was actually a way to save Kirkland if we would have just shot quicker. Huh.
Fisher, glad to see you're doing better.
That was some expedition, hey? Captain said I'm going in the log as the first human to make contact with the Ket. And Kirkland's the first casualty. Wish it could have gone differently.
I'm sure there are decent aliens here in Andromeda, too. We just have to find them.
Well, I heard you're Pathfinder now. Sooner you figure out where they're hiding, the better.
Will do. Chin up.
You, Dr. Kylisle.
Ryder, good to see you. Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
I'm sure you did everything you could.
Yeah, but still, we lost a Pathfinder on my watch. Doesn't sit right.
My dad knew the danger. Part of the job.
Now I just need to make sure your sister here pulls through.
Ah, she's out of the box now.
So you and Lexi swapped jobs?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by. So it made sense that Lexi and I switched places. She's younger. Well, for Asari, they're still teenagers when they're 200. And she's one hell of a doctor. She'll serve the Tempest well.
What will you do on the Hyperion?
We still have thousands of people taking a nap here, and they need tending to. And this way I can look out for Sarah.
How's Sarah doing?
Her condition's stable. I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so she's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How'd this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another writer.
How did you end up with the Initiative?
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Sarah, I'll let you know.
Must do frequent checkups with sister. Scan all the things. Scan all the things. Information wall.
Hi there. I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Andromeda
Initiative.
I've seen
this already.
I'm here. The good news is, the hard part's over. We're here. If you have any questions now, just ask.
Okay. Now, what is in here? Oh, this is where they, where all the popsicles are stored. I woke up here. All right. It's one last person to talk to. I can't examine my sister, can I? Nope.
Ryder.
Ace, how's the wound?
Doc says I'll live. So this goes from a life-threatening gunshot to a story I'll tell my grandkids someday.
With no need to exaggerate, that was a tough fight on Habitat 7.
Just glad to be on the other side of it.
Okay, then. Alright, let's head back to the docking bay. Then I have one person to talk to. It's a side mission, I think. And then we'll head back to the Tempest, and there should be a whole ton of dialogue stuff that has opened up for us. You.
Pathfinder, do you have just... Ryder, isn't it? Kerry Tavessa, freelance vidmaker. This is Hakim, my producer. I could use your help.
What are you looking for?
Director Tanz asked for an uplifting documentary on the initiative. Translation, paint rainbows over our problems. But our problems are history. People deserve the truth, not propaganda.
Nice to see someone so devoted to her work.
That's kind. Sometimes the camera makes people shy away from me.
That's a shame.
So that's what I need. The truth, I mean. Someone needs to record the history we're making.
It takes integrity to record the truth and nothing but.
Well, I do my best. And you could help me out. The heart of my documentary will be an interview series. I was hoping you'd take part. I want the dirt and blood of our story, not the convenient fairy tale Tan's looking for. Interested?
You don't mind treading on the initiative director's toes?
What would he do? Pool funding we don't have. I'm game if you are.
Okay, interview away.
Let's start at home. 14 months and the Nexus still isn't finished. Arcs are missing, we have people in exile. By any standard, this wasn't the plan. Our leadership describes these as anticipated issues. Would you agree?
All expeditions have to deal with supplies, enemies, or hell, just getting lost. We'll deal with all of them. We just need time.
Tan will love that. But if that's your take, that's what goes in. Bandwidth means I'm transmitting in short bursts, so that's all for now. But you can bet I'll have more questions later. This was more fun than I expected. You were great. I'll get to work editing.
It's on. Next mission is on hold. Okay. Let's hop back into the Tempest. Tempest, take flight! I didn't know you spoke Tempest. Okay.
Oh, Gil wanted you to check in.
Who's Gil again? Too many people.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector?
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
You mentioned something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I like the Tempest, but I'm not sure I'd travel between galaxies for her.
The unknown frontier had its charms, too. It's just strange not having the rest of the design team. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, three drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Did you hear anything about the arc back in the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
Cheer up, Callow. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
Building those relationships.
Ah, Pathfinder. It's so wonderful to meet you. I'm Dr. Suvi Anwar, assigned to act as liaison between your crew and the Nexus science team.
What do you mean, liaison? Are you gonna tell on me?
Of course not. Not interested in politics. I advise only on the science. I've studied all the planetary scans. I've even had some hands-on experience with Helios soil samples. If you want, I'll send you my analysis on the native bacteria and microfauna. 60 pages.
That's a lot of pages. About dirt.
Oh, you don't have to be kind. I know it's barely more than a summary. Anyway, I've waited months to get out there to see Helios. It's why I joined the Initiative. The Milky Way was just a corner of a vast universe, a corner of a tiny corner. We're the ones who got to step out of that corner. It's incredible!
I guarded a mass relay for some time. I always wanted to see the other side.
I totally know what you mean.
So will you be joining us on missions?
Oh, that's funny. Me, out there, with the guns and the danger and everything.
But don't you want to experience everything firsthand? I know I'd want to.
Oh, absolutely. But I know my strengths. Trust me, I'm far more useful to you in the laboratory. Anyway, I've just received some instructions from the science team, and I really should go over them. Later, then.
Hey, I'm the one who ends the conversations. Not you. What is this? Oh. $10, we're gonna be hitting that. At some point. The escape pod. Loadout station. Omniblade. M3 Predator. I'm gonna swap that out with a sniper rifle. Yeah. Fitness level. Oh, so that's why I had to unlock combat fitness. Okay. That's cool.
Strike team ready
Ryder,
for deployment.
When you've got a minute, stop by the med bay.
Okay. Forget where the med bay is. Oh, I forgot to check my father's office in the. Damn it. Don't break an ankle.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years on the Hyperion looking after your sister.
Happy to have you, Dr. DePiro.
I'll do my best. Now, hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the Initiative.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe?
Oh. Thing is, Ryder, you're not my type.
What's your type?
Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically without distractions.
Am I distracting?
Not nearly as much as you think you are. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan.
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats his vegetables.
Reconfigure there. I kind of want to head into engineering. Because there's a person I wanted to talk to.